prithee, good Mercutio, let's retire. The day is hot and the capels are abrawl. And if we meet, we shall not scape a brawl. For these hot days is the mad blood stirring.
Thou art like one of these fellows that enters the confines of tavern and clasps me a sword upon the table and says, God send me no need of thee. And by the operation of the second cup, draws him upon the drawer, when indeed there is no need.
Am I like such a fellow?
Come, come, thou art as hot as Jack in thy mood as any in Italy, and as soon moved to be moody as moody to be moved.
And what too?
Nay, and there were two such, we should have had one shortly, for one will kill the other, and thou wilt quarrel with a man that hath a hair more or a hair less in his beard than thou hast. Thou wilt quarrel with a man for cracking nuts, having no other reason but because thou hast hazel eyes. What eye but such an eye would spy out such a quarrel? Thy head is as full of quarrels as an egg is full of meat, and thy head hath been beaten as idle as an egg for quarreling. Thou hast quarreled with a man for coughing in the street, because he hath wakened the dog that lay asleep in the sun. Didst thou not fall out with a tailor for wearing his new doublet before Easter, with another for tying his new shoes with an old riband? And yet thou wilt tutor me from quarreling?
And I were so apt to quarrel as thou art, any man should buy the fee, simple, of my life for an hour and a quarter.
The fee, simple. Oh, simple.
By my head, here come the Capulets.
By my heel, I care not.
Follow me close, or I'll speak to them. Gentlemen, good then, a word with one of you.
But one word with one of us? Couple it with something. Make it a word and a blow.
You shall find me apt enough to that, sir, and will you give me occasion?
Could you not take some occasion without giving?
Mercutio, thou consortest with Romeo.
Consort? What does that make us, minstrels? And thou make minstrels of us. Look to hear nothing but discords. Here's my fiddlestick, and that shall make you dance. Zounds, consort.
We talk here in the public haunt of men. Either withdraw unto some private place, or reason coldly of your grievances, or else depart. Here all eyes gaze on us.
Men's eyes are made to look. Let them gaze. I will not budge for no man's pleasure. I.
Well, peace be with you, sir. Here comes my man.
But I'll be hanged, sir, if you wear your livery. Mary, go before to field. He'll be your follower. Your worship, in that sense, many may call him man.
Ah, blast the sun!
Romeo, the love I bear thee can afford no better term than this. Thou art a villain.
Tybalt, the reason that I have to love thee doth much excuse the appertaining race to such a greeting. Villain, I am none. Therefore, farewell. I see thou knowest me not.
Boy, this shall not excuse the injuries that thou hast done me. Therefore, turn and draw.
I do protest I never injured thee, but love thee better than thou canst devise. Until thou know the reasons of my love. Therefore, good Capulet, which am I tender dearly as my own, be satisfied.
Oh, calm, dishonorable, vile submission. Alla staccato. It away. Carries it away, Tybalt, you rat catcher. Will you walk?
What would thou have with me?
Good King of Cats, nothing but one of your nine lives, that I mean to make bold withal, and as you shall use me hereafter. Dry beat the rest of the eight. Will you pluck your sword out of the pilter by the ears? Make haste, lest mine be about your ears, as ear it be out.
I am for you.
Come, sir, your passado.
Dragon Folio, beat down their weapons. For, gentlemen, for shame, forbear this outrage. Tybalt, Mercutio, the prince expressly hath forbid dandying for on the street. Hold Tybalt, King Mercutio.
I am hurt. The plague of both houses. I am sped. Begone and hath nothing more. Nothing?
What, art thou hurt?
Aye, a scratch. Mary, 'tis enough. Where's my page? Go, villain, fetch a surgeon.
Hurt, man, the hurt cannot be much.
No, 'tis not so deep as a well, nor so wide as a church door. But 'tis enough, 'twill serve. After me tomorrow and you'll find me a grave man. I am peppered, I warrant, for this world. A plague of both your houses. Zounds, dog, rat, a mouse, a catch, a scratch, a man's death, a baggart, a rogue, a villain that fights with the book of arithmetic. Why the devil come you between us?
I thought off of the best.
He was hurt under my arm. Help me into some house, Benvolio, or I shall faint. A plague of both your houses. They've made worms meat of me. Have it, and soundly too. Your houses!
This gentleman, the Princess Nir Isla, my very friend, hath got this mortal hurt in my behalf. My reputation stained by Tybalt's slander. Tybalt, that an hour hath been my cousin. Oh, sweet Juliet, thy beauty hath made me effeminate, and thy temper softened valor's steel.
Romeo, Romeo, brave Mercutio is dead. That gallant spirit hath aspired to the clouds, which too untimely here did scorn the earth.
This day's black fate on Modoth's the pen, but this begins the woe others must end.
Here comes the furious Tybalt back again.
He gone in triumph, and Mercutio slain. Away to heaven, respective lenity, and fire-eyed fury, be conduct now. Now, Tybalt, take the villain back that late thou gavest me, for Mercutio's soul is but a little way above our heads. To keep him company, either thou or I or both must go with him.
The wretched boy didn't turn a hero. Now with him hence!
Fool.
Which way ran he that killed Mercutio? Tybalt, that murderer. Which way ran he?
There lies Tybalt.
Up, sir, go with me. I charge thee in the prince's name, obey.
Where are the beginners of this vile fray? O noble prince, I can discover all the unlucky manage of this fatal brawl. There lies the man slain by young Romeo that slew that kingdom praised Mercutio.
Tybalt, my cousin, O my brother's child, O prince, O husband, the blood of this spilled of my dear kinsman. Prince, as thou art true, first shed blood of ours, shed blood of Montague. O cousin, cousin! Benvolio, who began this bloody fray?
Tybalt here slain, whose Romeo's hand did slay. Romeo that spoke him fair, bethink how nice the quarrel was, and urged withal your high displeasure. All this, uttered with gentle breath, calm look, knees humbly bowed, could not trace the truce with unruly spleen of Tybalt dead to peace. But then he tilts with piercing steel at bold Mercutio's breast, who all is hot turns deadly point to point, and with martial scorn, with one hand beats cold death aside, with the other bends, sends it back to Tybalt, whose dexterity retorts it. Romeo, who cries aloud, friends, part, friends. And swifter than his tongue, his agile arm beats down their fatal points, and twixt them rushes, underneath whose arm are envious thrust from Tybalt, hit the life of stout Mercutio, and then Tybalt fled. By and by comes he back to Romeo, who had but newly entertained revenge, and today they go like lightning, for I could draw to part them, was stout Tybalt slain, and as he fell did Romeo turn and fly. This is the truth, or let Benvolio die.
He is a kinsman to the Montague. Affection makes him false. He speaks not true. Some 20 of them fought in this black strife, and all those 20 could kill but one life. I beg for justice, which thou must give. Romeo slew Tybalt. Romeo must not live.
Romeo slew Tybalt. Tybalt slew Mercutio. Who now the price of his dear blood doth owe?
Romeo, prince. He was Mercutio's friend. His fault concludes but what the lot should end.
And for that offense, immediately we do exile him hence. I have an interest in your heart's proceeding. My blood for your rude brawls doth lie a-bleeding. But I'll immerse you with so strong a fine that you shall repent the loss of mine. I will be deaf to pleading excuses, nor tears, nor prayers shall purchase out abuses. Therefore use none. Let Romeo hence in haste, for when he is found, that hour shall be his last. Bear hence this body and attend our will. Mercy but murders, pardoning those that kill.